Now this happens with me a lot of times that, you know, I'm working on a big data file in Excel and suddenly Excel hangs. Sounds familiar, right? Now in this case, the only option that I left with is to force quit Excel, because when I try to hit the close button, it doesn't work. Now in this video, I'm going to show you three simple ways to force quit or force close Excel whenever it hangs and you don't find any way to make it work back. So make sure to watch this video till the end, and now let's get started. All right, so the first way to force close Excel is to use the task manager, and for this you just need to go to your Windows task bar and then you need to right click and open the task manager. Now from the task manager, when you go to the processes tab, you will find Microsoft Excel there, and you just need to right click and click on end task. And again, I just want to remind you that when you click on end task, it will close the application and you might not get all the changes that you have made in the file. So I'll click on end task, and you can see within a few seconds the application will be force closed by Windows. Now here you can see when I reopen that same file which I force closed using task manager, I have got this option to recover my document. So I just want you to, whenever you're using any Excel workbook, make sure to turn on your autosave. Now let me move to the second way of force quit Excel, and that's by using the run dialog box. So you need to press the shortcut key, Windows key and R, and it will open the run dialog box. Now here you need to enter a specific line, that is taskkill and then a space and forward slash F and then space and again forward slash IM space excel.exe. Now the moment you click OK, and all the opened Excel workbooks will be closed. Now third method to force quit Excel is by using PowerShell. So for this you just need to go to your start menu and search for PowerShell, and when you open the PowerShell, you just need to paste a simple single line of code, and that's stop hyphen process and then again hyphen namespace Excel space hyphen and force. Now the moment I hit enter and go to the next line, this line of code will completely close Excel file with all the workbooks which are open right now, and you can again open Excel and find your file if that file is in auto recovery list. And if you are using MacBook, you can use two different ways to force quit Excel in a MacBook. So first of all is by using the terminal. So what I'll do, I'll press the keyboard shortcut Control plus space, and then I'm going to type terminal, which is already open in my case. And now I just need to enter a small line of command, and that's kill all and then space double quotation marks start Microsoft Excel Microsoft and double quotation marks closed. And now the moment I hit enter, it will force close Excel application entirely. Yes, that's now let me open it again and show you the second way of, you know, force quit Excel. Now for this, you need to open the activity monitor, just like we have task manager in Windows. For this, I'm going to use the keyboard shortcut command and space, and then I'm going to type activity monitor. And in the activity monitor, I just need to go to memory and then select the Microsoft Excel application that is open right now. And once I select it, I just need to click on the stop button, and it will close Excel application entirely, including all the workbooks that are open.